So for program 7, we're going to read some values from a file and then sort them and run some statistics on them. So that's several different things, but let's think about what's the core of this program. So the core of this program is we're going to get some values in and we're going to sort them, and then we're going to have some functions to do some things. So let's think about just trying to get the kind of the core part of this program working together. So let's use a vector, because this one's going to run on the computer. Whoops, sorry. So we might as well use vector and have all the functions and everything that the vector comes with instead of trying to deal with arrays. And let's also organize everything in a class. So let's call this class stats. Let's get our private and public part going. So we know that we're going to have some kind of constructor. And we might not really even need to pass the constructor anything. So let's just start off with a default constructor. We can add to it as we need to. Thinking about the data that we're going to have some kind of vector that's going to hold these temperature values. So these are going to be floats or doubles. So let's do a vector of type double. Let's just call it V. Let's just do an empty vector. And then as we go, we're going to also do a mean, median, and mode of our vector. You could also argue maybe that you want to keep a sorted and an unsorted vector. Either one would be fine, but just kind of keeping it to the minimum, we could probably just handle this single vector and then just sort it as we go. And then, so let's think about what we'd want our stats to do. So our default constructor, probably just get everything set up. So we want to read in the values. And then we need to do some kind of sort function. Now, our sort function, you could argue that it could be private and just part of the class, or it could be public. Either way, let's just keep it simple. Let's just do it in public. We're going to use a keyword sort as part of an algorithm sort. So I'm going to not call it sort. I want to call it something slightly different. So let's just call it sort vect. And the vector is already going to be part of the class, so I don't need to pass it anything, and I shouldn't have to return it anything. And then after it's sorted, probably want to actually do the statistical analysis, so let's put that in a separate function. And then once we've got the statistical analysis run, then we could return the mean. So we'll do this as get mean. We could return the median. So get median. And then we could return the mode. Oops, so let's do get mode. Okay, now let's think about how we would kind of set this up in main. So we need to create an instance of our class, so it'd be stats, my stats. We're just using the default constructor, so no open close parentheses. And then next thing we do is we want to sort it. Open close parentheses, and then we'd need to do my stats dot run stats, and then we could start printing out the values. So just a statement to print that out. And we'll just print it out really simple. You could go back and add a table later if you needed to. Alright, so I'd kind of like to run this program and see how it's going, but if we do, we're going to get a bunch of errors because we don't have any of these things enabled yet. Let's see, it looks like I do have I do have a syntax error here. This should be mystats.getMedian. Let me start a new line here. And mystats.getMode. Let's try and run it again. Okay, yeah, we haven't enabled that code yet, so we're getting that error. But it's not a bad idea just to try and run it and see if you get some, if you can sort out some syntax errors. Now let's go back into here and start creating the enabling code for these functions. So these would belong to class stats. So it'd be stats. This is our constructor, so it would be void. And then we'll have stats sort vect of type void, and this return type was void, so I put the void in front and open close. And let's see what else I need. I need void stats run stats void, and then I need double stats get mean void, and then this would return the mean. And just so I don't get an error later, I'm going to set the mean, median, and mode to 1. Let's do 1.0. Whoops. Okay, so we've got get mean, let's do get median, and then get mode. So there's get median. And there's get mode. And we need to change this to be median. And we need to change this to be mode. Okay, so let's run it again. Let's see what kind of errors we have now. Okay. Expected a... declaration... let's see, vector. Oh, and I'm missing the equal sign there. It was kind of a cryptic error. Okay, so I've got it running, and it's printing out the values. So now we've made it sort of through this declaration of everything. Let's start putting some stuff in here. So doing a file kind of is its own thing. So let me let you work on that. But I'm just going to put in a for loop in here while we're working on it, just to kind of get it working, and then just replace this later with the code that you need to open and read from a file. Let's just read in maybe 10 values. Now I want to read it into that vector and I want to use pushback, but I can't push back directly from CN. So I'm going to have to read into a temporary storage location. So I need to declare that storage location. So it needs to be the same type as my vector. So let's call it double data. We'll put it up here. Once I read it in, now I can push it onto my vector. So the code's going to be v.push underscore back open parentheses, and then whatever you're pushing onto the vector. So now we've got this for loop to push some stuff onto the vector. Let's run it again, make sure this is working. Let's see, what did I do here? Oh, just a typo here. I missed the I. And let's run it again. Okay, so it's going to give me values, so 10.1. Okay. Okay, so it looks good. It's reading in those values. You know what would be really nice would be able to print that vector out. And I think we're going to wind up using that code a lot. So let's put that as a private, because that would be something that's interacting with stats probably shouldn't be having access to what's in the stats, should be managing that. So we're going to do void, because it's not going to return anything. And then we'll do print v, and then it'll be receiving type void. And let's just put it right here. So I'm going to just copy this down, place it here. Return type goes in front, and then we need stats, colon, colon, in front of print v. We're going to do the enabling code, so we're going to take off that semicolon. And to print this out, let me borrow this for loop that we used here and just dump it in here. And for this one, we'll do int I. I is going to go up to the size of the vector. So this would be v.size, and then open close parentheses so that we're using it as a function. Let's just print out here is what's in the vector. And this is just code that we're going to be using for debugging. We wouldn't really probably even need to use this code in our final program if we're just going to print out the statistics summary. So for a cout statement, what we're going to do is just print out v, and then we'll do the square brackets, and then we'll do I. So I is going to go from 0 up to the size of the vector. So it should print out all the elements, and we don't need this part here. So let's run it again and make for sure that this is working. And let's try and use print v down here. Because we're in the class, we should be able to just run it this way. If we want to make for sure, double for sure, that we're getting the one that belongs to the class, we could do stats colon colon in front of it. Okay, and looks like I made a syntax error here. Instead of ENDL, so I had an extra C out there instead of an ENDL. And this is again why I'm not intentionally trying to make typos, but this is again why I recommend trying to run your code fairly frequently. Just get those little typos out as you go, because you know that if it's running and you added 5-10 lines, then you know, hey, it's got to be somewhere in those 5 or 10 lines that I just added There we go. So it printed everything out. So we got everything that we just typed in. Okay, so now let's see if we can get that vector sorted. And that would be kind of the main thrust of this program. We'd sort of have most of it worked out. We'd have to go back and figure out how to pull the mean, median, and mode out of the stats, but we could do that later. And we'd also have to figure out how to read in from that data file. We could kind of do that later, fill that in as another detail. So the sort that we're going to be using is this one that's an algorithm. So pound sign include algorithm. And let's put the sort under sort vect. Okay. So again, just to help debug it, let's print out the vector again. Even though we just printed it out, let's just print it out again and sort, just to make for sure that we've got the vector that it's being accessed correctly. So same code that we had up here. And then now let's use our sort. So it'll be std colon colon sort. And this would be v dot. We need to send it the first value and the last value. So with our vector, it's really simple because our vector has these functions begin and end. So we can just send it v dot begin, comma, v dot end, and it'll sort between the beginning and the ending values, so it'll sort the whole vector. And then let's print out the sorted vector. And that should be the same code to print that out. All right, let's run it again and see what we get. So we entered it, we printed it out immediately. Here is the vector that's unsorted. You can see it's the identical vector, so there's not a problem in our code where the vector's getting lost between those two functions since they both belong to the same class and it's private. And then here's our sorted vector. So now think about how you would calculate mean. So maybe think about using a for loop and try and build that process in. So can you build a for loop that's going to add up all those values, get a total, and then at the end divide by maybe the size of the vector? That would give you that flexibility to handle any number of values. Think about with your median. You could get more sophisticated with your median. If you have two middle values, you could average the two middle values, or you could just always pick the one side. Either way would be fine for this program. Mode is probably the trickiest. So think about how you could do mode, and think about how you could do mode in that same for loop that you're using for mean. Kind of flowchart it out. Try to do mode last. See if you can get mean and median working. But hopefully this kind of gives you a scaffolding that you can use to start building your program to start sorting those temperature datas. And again, I would keep it fairly simple in the beginning. Just do some keyboard entry because you know you can get that working quickly. And then once your program gets working, you can always go back and add more detail to it. But think about programming as mapping out the overall structure of your program, and then just adding that detail as you go. Don't get caught up in trying to figure out every single last detail. Figure that stuff out as you go. That's usually a much faster way to program. Thanks for watching.